remarkable girl. She actually knows her words well. Ah, thanks, love. Well, in a way, you've got to admire her.
Yes, I could see you had to.
So few people actually choose a way of life.
Well, you did, Rumpole.
Eh?
You chose Hilda.
Ah, the lady wife, yes. She who must be obeyed. I had no choice in the matter at all. I was called up to marriage like military service. Her father was head of chambers. He gave me to understand what was expected of me.
Well, you've been together so long, and your son.
Did you know Nick was in Oxford?
No.
Yes. He's the bright one of the family. Yeah, so Hilda and I left looking at each other like, well, like a couple of strangers forced to share the same sleeper on some endless railway journey. Me and she who must
be obeyed.
You know, if I had ever exercised a free and independent choice...
What?
I would have said something to you at that hop.
New Year's Eve at the Naffy?
Well, I had you to myself for 2 whole hours. Sam was off on a round trip to Dusseldorf. Plenty of time to come to some sort of decision.
You never said a word.
No. Well, perhaps I took it for granted. You were never meant for the lowly ground staff. Well, that's a mistake I shan't ever make again. Well, if you don't say anything, nobody ever knows.
You're smelling rather lovely today.
Oh, it's some new aftershave. Oh. Saw it in the chemist. I went for a stroll before breakfast. It's by way of a celebration.
Celebrating what?
Holiday. And a case with all sorts of possibilities.
Ah, the lotus eaters are in force. Clean jeans, statutory baby. Let's hope they don't mistake the whole thing for a bit of fun round the South African embassy.
Morning! You must be Rumpole.
What have we here? Gentleman farmer, gentleman barrister.
Welcome to the Western Circuit.
Probably got jodhpur boots on under the pinstripe.
Took, Vernon Took's my name. I'm prosecuting you.
Awfully decent of you.
I say, Rumpole, where'd you get that shower from? Rent a hippie. What a life, eh? Gang bangs on the national assistance.
Do I detect in Farmer Took's voice a note of envy?
Used to be a decent area, Balaclava Road, till that lot got their foot in the door. What, squatters are they?
They've got a 9-year lease on the house and they've all got jobs. No, the only fellas scrounging off the state, Took, are you and I.
Really, Rumpo?
Well, they are paying you on the rates, aren't they?
Oh, most amusing. I say, Rumpole, is this going to take long? It's the Coal Sands Gymkhana tomorrow. We tend to make it rather a day out.
Ah, long? No, I shouldn't think so. It's quite a nice point of law.
Point of law, Rumpole?
Oh, you do have law down here on the Western Circuit, I take it.
You a lawyer?
This is Dave.
Oh, yes?
Dave Hawkins, a friend of mine.
Mm-hmm. Will Cathy be going in today?
In?
Into the witness box. There's something I wanted to say, and it's
Dave, do you mind if I call you Mr. Hawkins? If I were a surgeon, old darling, taking out your appendix, you wouldn't want Cathy here telling me where to put the knife, now, would you?
Catherine Trelawney!
Yes! You'd better answer to Dale.
Will they lock me up now?
Of course not, trust me.
Trelawney?
Yes?
We can come in, can't we?
Of course you can, Mr. Hawkins. Provided you leave the work to me.
Beads. What beads were those?
I was wearing beads, Your Honor, on the occasions of my visits to 34 Balaclava Road.
Beads? With the uniform?
Not with the uniform, Your Honor. With the embroidered jeans and the woven headband, the purple silk drapery knotted round the neck. Oh, not forgetting the Afghan goat coat.
I was in plain clothes, Your Honor.
Plain clothes, Sergeant? You were in fancy dress. Now, would you mind telling the court what's happened to your gaucho moustache?
I shaved it off.
Oh, why?
In view of certain comments, Your Honor, passed in the station. It wasn't a gaucho, it was more of Viva Zapata, actually.
Silence!
Viva? What was that, Mr. Rumpole?
The officer was affecting the moustache, Your Honor, of a well-known South American revolutionary.
South American? Can you tell me, officer, what is the purpose of this elaborate disguise?
May I suggest an answer, Sergeant? You took it into your head to pose as a drug dealer in order to trap this quite innocent young woman into a taking part in a filthy trade she wouldn't otherwise have dreamt of.
She wasn't so innocent.
Oh, indeed. What led you to suppose that?
Her way of life, Your Honor.
Yes. What I want you to tell me, officer, is this. Did you have any reason to believe that this young woman was dealing in drugs before you went there in your viva...
What? Zapata, Your Honor.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Rumpole. Much obliged.
We had received certain information.
Well, will you let us in on the secret, Sergeant? What was this information?
That Miss Trelawney was the type to get involved.
Involved by you?
Involved already.
I shall be calling the evidence, Your Honor, of the neighbor, Miss Tigwell.
Very well, Mr. Took.
Do try and sit quietly, Took.
But if the evidence shows no previous attempt to deal in drugs, you would have to agree that this whole crime is a result of your fertile imagination.
Doesn't it rather depend, Mr. Rumpole, on the effect of the evidence of Miss Tigwell when we hear it?
If Your Honor pleases. Of course, as always, Your Honor is perfectly right. Thank you, Sergeant.
Miss Tigwell? Is that all you're going to ask?
Oh, do you want to have a go? Do borrow the wig, old darling.
Will you please keep that baby quiet? This is a court of law, madam.
I'm sorry. The baby didn't know.
I could tell exactly what they were.
And what were they exactly, Miss Tigwell?
Perverted.
Really?
All living higgledy-piggledy, men and women, black and white.
Did your observation include the bedrooms?
Well, no. But they all sat together in the front room.
Sat together? What did they talk about?
Oh, I couldn't hear that.
They were a community, that's all it comes to. They might well have been Trappist monks, for all you knew.
I don't know if Mr. Rumpole is suggesting that his client is a Trappist monk.
Just sit quietly, Took. Leave the jokes to me, old darling.
Now, Miss Tigwell, apart from the fact that people of different sexes sat together, did you ever observe anything suspicious from your post in the crow's nest?
I saw a man giving her money. Quite a lot of it. It was in £10 notes.
Was this the first time you had ever seen money change hands, or indeed any sort of dealing going on in Nirvana?
The first time, yes.
Now, will you just describe to His Honor the man you saw passing this money?
Dreadful-looking person. A clear criminal type. He looked as if he'd been dragged through a hedge backwards.
Long hair?
Oh, yes, and a revolting sort of moustache.
Beads, embroidered jeans, Afghan goat fur, and a purple silk fancy round the neck.
Disgusting. I saw it all quite distinctly.
Thank you, Miss Tigwell. You've now given us a perfectly accurate description of Detective Sergeant Smedley of the local force.
Silence!
Well, Mr. Rumpole, it's just after 4 o'clock. Would that be a convenient moment?
If Your Honor pleases.
Will you be much longer with Miss Tigwell?
I think I've finished with Miss Tigwell, Your Honor.
Yes, Mr. Rumpole, I think you have.
Be upstanding in court.